Hello, I'm Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Have you ever heard a riff like this before? Well, it's a basic blues boogie riff, and it can be moved all over the neck in several different ways. We can move it to other octaves like this. And we can also move it to other chords and format the riff across our song parts like this. Now, what's really great about these blues riffs is how they can stand on their own to replace chords. Plus, they can also be played along a backing riff in a 12-bar blues. In fact, here's that riff you just heard me play, but used as a backing riff in a 12-bar blues. An amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. All right, so let's break down what's happening here. The guitar neck is being divided up into three main areas. I like to think of them as low, middle, and high registers. And it's a good idea, whatever you learn, whether it's a scale, an arpeggio, maybe a guitar riff like this, if you learn it in one register, move it around to the other ones. It helps you to understand how everything you play can work all over the neck. Now, in this breakdown on the low end of the neck here, I've got this G riff starting off on the 3rd fret G on 6th string. Triplet-based idea comes up next with those chromatic notes, and then we go through the major pentatonic scale with another triplet coming up there on the second measure before we get into the wrap-up of the riff. Pointing a lot at that B note, very strong tone in either the G major chord or the G dominant 7th chord. All right, so that's taking care of the low register riff. Let's move up to the middle range idea now. It goes like this. So this one's starting off on 4th string, 5th fret G, and we're moving up again with the chromatic run. All these licks and riffs, they're all the same idea. And then we're gonna go up to the 3rd string, have this idea of the 7 and 9-7 taking us up to this 8th fret 2nd string tone. Then another triplet again, 9-7 and into 9 of 4th string. And then wrapping up with some of this 8th note major pentatonic idea there. And that takes care of our mid-range riff. Let's go to the high register idea now. It goes like this. Now with this high one, we have a big jump that we're doing. It's only located on a couple of strings for the most part. We only have one note really, or I guess, yeah, it's the one note on 16th fret 3rd string that we even play. But we're starting off on the G again at the 8th fret there, and we're moving into the chromatic run that's a triplet, 10, 11, 12, up to the high 10th fret on the 1st string, pulling off, jumping all the way to the 15th fret, and then we're having some work up there around 17 and 15. We had a 16 there on 3rd string, and then finish off into that 16th fret B on the 3rd string. We're jumping pretty far back to get this 8th fret G to return us to the top of that line once again. It's a big move, you know, it happens really fast, but, you know, you can get used to it. And what's really going to be nice is on the Patreon lesson, in the part two lesson, what we're going to be doing is taking a look at some really nice patterns and shapes going all across the guitar. There's a couple of ones that I got for you that are really nice, and it'll help get you used to moving along the neck with these shapes. There'll be some really good ones in there for soloing and for riff building. I'm going to look at them as geometrical patterns, and it's really going to solidify the stuff on the neck. I've also got some great stuff on Patreon coming up with guitar licks for you, and a really good theory lesson that explains exactly what's going on with these pentatonics, not just for the work we're focusing on here in the more the major and dominant sounds, but also I'm going to get you going on minor in that theory lesson as well. So I hope to see you next on Patreon. Just go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video for the second half of this lesson. And in the bonus video, I'm going to cover some of the best guitar neck patterns that there are for using the blues scale all over the neck. We'll cover ways to practice soloing, how to create licks and riffs, plus I've got example licks for you that apply all the ideas covered in the lesson. On top of all that, I've also got a detailed theory lesson that breaks down everything behind where blues scales come from, the styles it can be played in, and the harmonies that work to produce the best blues sound. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get jam tracks, and you'll also get to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.